கருவறை தாண்டிய நொடியில் எந்தன் காதில் ஏந்திய மொழியே உன்னை கருவறை தாண்டிய நொடியில் எந்தன் காதில் ஏந்திய மொழியே உன்னை கடல் கடந்து வேர் கரை புகுந்தாலும் சிந்தை மகிழ வீச கண்டே சுவாசமாக சுவாசமாக கலந்த உன்னை தாயா சுவாசமாக கலந்த உன்னை தாயா நேசம் கொண்டேன் சுவாசமாக கலந்த உன்னை தாயா நேசம் கொண்டேன் தாய் தமிழே இந்தன் தாய் தமிழே தாய் தமிழேயின் தாய் தமிழே தாய் தமிழேயின் தாய் தமிழே தாய் தமிழேயின் தாய் தமிழே தாய் தமிழே தாய் தமிழே 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 தாய் தமிழேயின் தாய் தமிழே 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 உலக தமிழர் நெஞ்சில் எங்கும் நீ கமறி நிறைந்தவளே நீ வாழியவே உலக தமிழர் நெஞ்சில் எங்கும் நீ கமறி நிறைந்தவளே நீ வாழியவே பாடுகரை தேடி பாயும் ஒரு நேசநதி போலே தமிழரின் குருதி பாடுகரை தேடி பாயும் ஒரு நேசநதி போலே தமிழரின் குருதி தமிழோடும் தமிழே நீ வாழியவே எங்கும் வாழியவே தமிழோடும் தமிழே நீ வாழியவே தமிழ் வாழ்க
காலம் தொட்டே மூன்றின வேதம் விட்டே மாண்பென மண்ணை தொட்டே வாண்வரை செல்வோம் கிட்டே
பலமாய் நாம் சேர்கிறோம் பகை நோய் தீர்க்கிறோம்
கூற நாட்டை தேடு தோடா ஏதும் இல்லை பாரு வாழ்காய் வாழும் நாட்டின் மக்கள் சோகம் தீர்க்கும் சொந்தம் பாரு வீடு வேலையாகுமாய் நாமும் இங்கே வாழ்கிறோம் தோடாய் நாடிதே தேசம் புத்தம் கூது சாரல் மழையேதோ கதை பேசி கண்ணாம்பூச்சி ஆடுதே
எந்த நாடு போயிலும் சொந்த நாடு ஆகுமா தாய் மண் தாய்மையே
நேர்மையோடு நாமுமே நெஞ்சில் தேசம் போற்றுவோம் வீடாது நாடே
நாடே நாடு
A very good evening to the teachers, parents, and students. I'm Kalaivani from STKITI Ladang Dovenbi and will be the moderator for today's session. Before I start, I would like to thank all of you for joining us today in our YouTube Live Classroom, which is brought to you by Sudaruli Valayoli YouTube channel in collaboration with the Millennium Para Indian Community Society. I would like to convey our appreciation to the president of the society and former headmaster of STKT Bagansarai, Mr. R.P. Jayakopalan, and not forgetting the entire team working hard for us behind the scene, Ms. Parimala, our education officer from PPD Manjung, Mr. Gunalan, our education officer from PPD Manjung, Ms. Pusparata, the headmistress of STKT Kampung Columbia, Mr. Danish Balakrishnan, the High City teacher from STKT Ladang Nova Scotia 1, and Ms. Sarala Krishnan, the ICT teacher from STKT Kampung Tun Sambandan. I would like to thank our Human Resource Minister, Dr. M. Saravanan, the Para State Education Department, Para District Education Office, EDDAY, Minds App, Pertubuhan Kesusasteraan Bharati, and the online media, supporters enigan.com and Yen Tamil. Despite school being reopened, along with the recovery movement control order, the spirit to continue educating our children is still strong among us as educators. We greatly value and appreciate everyone's support towards the Sudarali Valayodi team. Your constant support helps to boost our confidence and motivate us to do more for our community. Therefore, please allow me to introduce the speaker for today's session. She is Miss Tenmoli, an English language teacher currently teaching at SGKT Ladang Elfield, Sungai Siput. She has been teaching English since year 2015. She is also the head of the English language panel. Today, she will be sharing her insights on English prepositions with of all of us. There are a few reminders for all viewers, especially to the students. First, please use the chat box for positive comments. Second, use appropriate language. Third, use the live chat to ask questions.
Yes, teacher, only me theriyudha unga pesitte okay teacher
Thank you, dear moderator. Good evening to everyone. It is my pleasure to join you all today at the Sudaroli Balayoli YouTube channel. First of all, I would like to extend my gratitude to the organizing team for giving me this opportunity to be the speaker for the today's lesson. I would like to take this opportunity as well to thank the Kuala Kangsar District Education Officer Encik Sahwan bin Rabal, the SISC Plus for Language Encik Jamaluddin bin Yahaya, the headmistress of SJKT Ladang Elfield, Madam Supalachmi, and to all my well wishers. All right. Hi, students. Hope you are doing well. Before I move on, I would like to introduce the topic that we are going through today. It's prepositions. Today's grammar lesson is specifically for year 4, year 5, and year 6 students. Dear students, before we move on into our today's lesson, let's have a quick review about the content of our lesson. First of all, as you can see, we are going to look into introduction, what are prepositions, types of prepositions, followed up by examples of prepositions. We all see coordinating prepositions in sentences, and then we will do some quick exercises together. Okay? Okay, I'm sure that you have answered preposition questions either in your examination or you were doing some worksheets. Here, I'm just going to explain where can we find preposition questions, especially in our exam paper. So if you look at this graphic, preposition questions tend to appear in our comprehension paper, which is paper 1. I'm sure, students, you are aware of this section, which is section A. Section A comprises of 20 questions. So the questions related to preposition might be come out in question 1 to 5, either in question 1 to 5 or question 7 to 9 or question 12 to 15. Okay, students, what are prepositions? Okay, prepositions are words which show the relationship of one person or thing or even to another. Prepositions show relationship between the nouns and pronouns and the other words in a sentence. Prepositions are never followed by verbs. Later, I will show you the examples of these sentences. Okay, types of prepositions. Let's have a look at the type of prepositions. There are a few types of prepositions. Okay, places and positions, time, directions, agent, similarity, and so on. So today, we are going to focus on places and positions. Okay, let's have a look at examples of prepositions. Prepositions that use for place and positions: in, at, on, behind, in front of, above, below, against, from, along, near, between, by, under, next to, or beside. Let's have a look at these students. Okay. Number one, behind. The ball is behind the box. Number two, between. The ball is between the two boxes. Number three, below. This is below. The ball is below the box. Next, in front of. The ball is in front of the box. Near. The ball is near the box. Next, the ball is in the box. Next, two. The ball is next to the box. Above. The ball is above the box. On. The ball is on the ball. For you to easy understand. Okay, next. Coordinating preposition in sentences. Okay, let's have a look on it. Number one. Okay. In. We live blank Ipoh. We live blank Ipoh. We live in Ipoh. Next. Nowadays, Peter spends a lot of his time alone, blank, his room, listening to the radio. Nowadays, Peter spends a lot of his time alone in his room, listening to the radio. From. I received a letter, blank, my friend, yesterday. I received a letter from my friend yesterday. Bharathan took the bus, blank, Ipoh bus station. Bharathan took the bus from Ipoh bus station. At. She bought a hammer at the hardware store. She bought a hammer at a hardware store. I was not blank home when he came. I was not at home when he came. Against. Okay. The boy is leaning blank the wall. So can you see the boy? Teacher put the photo for you for your view. The boy is leaning against the wall for you to easy to understand. Huh? Okay, next, against. Place the ladder against the wall. Place the ladder against the wall. Next, behind. She kept the broom, blank, the door yesterday. She kept the broom behind the door yesterday. Wong stands, blank, the door with smile. Can you see the boy? Yeah, he smiles, isn't it? Wong stands behind the door with smile. Next, near. Margaret sits blank a friend in class. Margaret sits near her friend in class. Next, the dog is blank the book. The dog is near the book. Along. I was walking blank the beach when I found this shell. I was walking along the beach when I found this shell. Between. Ahua is standing blank Agilan and Aisha. Ahua is standing between Agilan and Aisha. On. The book is blank the chair. The book is on the chair. By. Shruti is fishing blank the river. Shruti is fishing by the river. In front of, there is a telephone pole, blank our house. There is a telephone pole in front of our house. Above, he lives in a room, blank the shop. He lives in a room above the shop. Under, the cat is sleeping, blank the table. The cat is sleeping under the table. Hope you can imagine. Okay, next. Beside, John sits, blank Peter in class. John sits beside Peter in class. Next to, I sit, blank Ahmad in the classroom. I sit next to Ahmad in the classroom. Below, the teacher hangs the clock, blank the picture. The teacher hangs the clock below the picture. Dear students, hope you understand. Okay, now it's time for you test yourself. Okay. Okay, we look at part one. Fill in the blanks with the correct prepositions. There are four questions here. Okay, we start with first question. We are sitting, blank, a bench. Dear students, can you guess the answer? What's the answer, students? Look at the picture so that easy for you to answer. We are sitting on a bench. Okay? We are sitting on a bench. Now, look at question number two. Place the ladder, blank the wall. Place the ladder, blank the wall. The picture might help you to find the answer. What's the answer, students? Place the ladder. Against the wall. Okay, number three. The children are sitting, blank, the television. The children are sitting, blank, the television. Okay, look at the picture. Where are they sitting? The children are sitting in front of the television. Number four, the lamp is hanging, blank, my head. The lamp is hanging, blank, my head. Dear students, what's the answer? Look at the picture. Okay, the lamp is hanging above my head. Hope all of you Got correct. Okay, next. Part two. Okay, objective questions. Okay, now fill in the blanks with the correct prepositions. Okay, question number one. The gardener blank the tree and looked at the sea. The gardener sat blank the tree and looked at the sea. A, under. B, above. C, below. Look at the picture given here. Can you guess the answer, students? What's the answer? The gardener sat. Yes, the answer is A, under. The gardener sat under the tree and looked at the sea. Very good. Let's move on to question number two. She had been hiding blank a tree. She had been hiding blank a tree. A, at. B, by. C, behind. What's the answer, students? The answer is yes, C. The answer is C, behind. She had been hiding behind a tree. Question number three. Please don't lean blank the wall. Please don't lean blank the wall. A, at. B, against. C, from. The answer is B, against. Please don't lean against the wall. Very good, students. Next, question number four. I have something blank my bag for you. I have something blank my bag for you. A, into. B, from. C, in. It's easy to get the answer if you look at the pictures given here. I have something. The answer is C. I have something in my bag for you. Question number five. I will hang this picture blank the wall. I will hang this picture blank the wall. A, on. B, in. C, at. Yes, student. The answer is A. On. I will hang this picture on the wall. I will hang this picture on the wall. Question number 6. Last week, we went for a picnic. Blank. The waterfalls. Last week, we went for a picnic. Blank. The waterfalls. A. On. B. Against. C. Near. Dear students, hope you are answering the questions. The answer is C, near. Last week, we went for a picnic near the waterfalls. Last week, we went for a picnic near the waterfalls. Question number 7. Joyce sits blank her mom and dad. Joyce sits blank her mom and dad. A. Down. B. Between. C. On. Okay, students, the answer is B, between. Joyce sits between her mom and dad. Joyce sits between her mom and dad. Next question, question number 8. The road, blank, our house is very busy. The road, blank, our house is very busy. A. Above. B. In front of. C. In. What's the answer, students? Yes, the answer is B, in front of. The answer is B, in front of. Let me read the question with the answer. The road in front of our house is very busy. The road in front of our house is very busy. Question number 9. Never stand blank a tree during thunderstorm. In fact, you shouldn't even be blank it. I read it again. Never stand blank a tree during thunderstorm. In fact, you shouldn't even be blank it. A, above, followed by. B, under, followed by between. C, under, followed by near. Okay, students, take time to answer. Okay, the answer is C. Under followed by near. Let me read the sentence. Read the answer. Never stand under a tree during thunderstorm. In fact, you shouldn't even be near it. Never stand under a tree during thunderstorm. In fact, you shouldn't even be near it. Okay, students, let's have a look at the last questions. Question number 10. She was standing blank the gate blank the house when I passed blank her. She was standing blank the gate blank the house when I passed blank her. A, at, in front of, by. B, in, over, by. C, at, beside, from. Okay, the answer is What's the answer? The answer is A. At, in front of, by. Okay, let me read the sentence with the answer. She was standing at the gate in front of the house when I passed by her. She was standing at the gate in front of the house when I passed by her. Well done, students. Okay. So that's all from me, students. I hope my slides and explanation have given you a clear understanding. All the best, my dear students. That's all from me. Thank you.
Thank you, teacher, for your clear explanation on the topic. On the behalf of the Sudaruli Valioli team, we would like to thank Ms. Tenmoli for spending her time and giving some useful information. Special thanks to all our viewers out there for being with us throughout the session, whether on YouTube or Facebook Live. Don't forget to subscribe our channel and click the notification bell for upcoming classes. That's all for today. We shall meet you again in the next lesson. Take care and goodbye.